When the land is cropped, it is covered with plants. But post-harvest, they bear the effect and look of a desert. And today, we are paying an enormous price due to this style of farming. Once the paddy crop gets harvested, the farmers around here broadcast the pulses seeds. Broadcasting is a method of sowing wherein seeds are just thrown on the land with hand and allowed to grow. With copious monsoon rains for 3 months, lots of moisture is retained in the soil. Taking advantage of this, pulse crops are grown. And why broadcasting method? Because it is the easiest and incurs the least labor and cost. But in this method, the plant density on the field was not uniform and the yield was also very less. Our accounts manager who was visiting even felt, why such a less yield with so much effort and time?
No profit is hard work. We are getting is that this thing is 20 rupees to 250 grams, right?
Yeah.
We have to cut it, remove, put
labor water, charge.
And this is a labor.
That definitely was a certificate of disqualification from the finance department. In the subsequent season, we decided to do row plantation of the pulses. We made rows using a tractor and seeds were sown. This ensured a uniform plant population throughout the field. We sowed green gram, chenna or Bengal gram, and field bean or wal as it is called in Maharashtra. The yield was also much better than the previous. We also made some raised beds for vegetables and greens. Initially, when human beings started farming, they needed agricultural lands to start with. They cleared forest trees and made space for farming. Once they were done with that place, some would shift to another place looking for new virgin lands. This continued for many thousands of years. The earlier farmed lands were left barren. Being continuously exposed to the elements of sunlight, wind and rains, these barren lands lost their topsoil and eventually became deserts. With the population explosion, there was no more new places to shift to. People started settling down. With modernization of farming, cultivation is done over hundreds and thousands of acres. And for the ease of operation, they are deprived of trees. When the land is cropped, it is covered with plants. But post-harvest, they bear the effect and look of a desert. And today, we are paying an enormous price due to this style of farming. Soil in its vertical section can be broadly classified into topsoil, subsoil, and bedrock. The organic matter on the very top and the soil beneath contains millions of bacteria, fungi, and earthworms and other insects. When we use a tractor and plow the land, the tillage happens only in the topsoil layer. It exposes the soil to the sun, leading to death of the microbes. Most of the agricultural crops like paddy, wheat and vegetables extend their roots only in the topsoil region. After the harvest of these crops, the land lies open to the natural forces for the majority of the months in a year, leading to runoff and soil erosion. In India, most of the farmers' land holdings are small. With the Green Revolution in the 1960s, the government and the scientists pushed for food grain production as the foremost goal. The trees were cut down because they were seen as culprits which stole the nutrition away from the main crop. Chemical fertility of the soil was researched extensively, but the biological fertility was very badly understudied by the scientists. And this has directed the mindset of the farmers that even after 60 years, it has become difficult to change them. In the last 2 to 3 decades, natural and organic farming enthusiasts and even environmentalists are working hard to spread this awareness of growing trees in farmlands. We planted 25 mango saplings, few sapota trees, jackfruit, lemon and guava trees. As our land had not been surveyed yet, we did not want to start planting along the fences. So we planted inside the land in 2 rows, thereby dividing the whole land into 3 segments. Once our land survey is done and our land's boundaries are demarcated, we will be planting trees all along the fences as well. Growing trees along the edges of the land and in between has many advantages. Deep roots of the trees break through the subsoil. The nutrients that are only available in subsoil layers are absorbed by the tree roots. These are accumulated in the leaves and fall back as manure on topsoil. Water retention capacity of soil increases, prevents soil erosion and runoff of nutrients. Border trees act as wind barriers. They reduce speed and temperature of wind, thereby preserving water loss due to evaporation. In India, there are around 40 species of birds that feed on the insects and pests in farmlands. Trees provide shelter for their nests and the birds take care of the pest management in the farm. We hope this video has brought you new information and awareness regarding the soil as a living, dynamic entity and the need for planting trees in farmlands. Share this video and let us help in bringing about the change that is very much needed right now.